So the first thing we're going to talk about is the use of cursors and sessions. Now this demo that we're going to look at, we're going to start the demonstration running along and we'll see it running at its most suboptimal. The reasons for this will become very obvious because you will notice that the number of logons taking place on this demo per second is almost identical to the transaction rate. In this case, the developer had made the mistake to log on for every transaction taking place in the database. Now, logging onto the database is an extremely expensive operation. Likewise, logging off from the database is an extremely expensive operation. So, as people evolve their applications, they need to learn how to use a connection pool so that they share the connections to the database and you don't incur the cost of logging on and off to the database. This is a big deal, okay? Back in 1999, when the dot-com craziness was taking place, people forgot this and they wrote, per se, stateless middleware. And stateless middleware meant that they just basically disconnected from the database until they actually needed to make a SQL request. And then they logged back onto the database, made a request, and then logged back off. These companies lasted between 3 and 6 months before they either learned to use a connection pool or they literally ran out of business. And this is, you know, a harsh fact. Very often it's very quick to prototype an application that looks great on a laptop with one user by doing these sort of techniques, but when they scale up to enterprise class and web scale type of things, they just will not scale. And so here we are demonstrating an application running that may be built by, say, an intern student or something like that, and you can see that the performance in terms of response time is nothing clever. It should be 1 or 2 milliseconds. You'll notice it's much greater than that. And we should be hitting thousands of transactions per second, but we're barely achieving 300. If we actually look at the operating system, we'll notice that the operating system is getting up there to be 50% busy. And if you actually subdivide where we're spending the busy time in the operating system, you'll notice that half the time itself is actually being spent inside the Linux kernel. That means that we're not even executing database code, we're executing code in the operating system. Code inside of the operating system doesn't get you any work done, it just utilizes the CPU managing the system. And in this case, what we're seeing is that when we log on and off to the database, it costs us a lot in terms of kernel time, literally mapping the SGA in and out of process address space as we create processes and tear them down. This is incredibly resource intensive. You'll also notice that we can't actually get the CPU use fully utilized because eventually the Linux kernel will serialize just managing all those shared memory pages. So we're talking about here is an application that's been written fairly suboptimally, in fact, completely suboptimally. As a result, it had a target response time of over 20,000 transactions a second, but if we actually have a look at it and we interrogate the screen in the top lines, we can see that we're only achieving about 200 to 300 transactions a second. And the response time for the transactions at the screen level is about quarter of a second, 230 milliseconds. So you can see not a great transaction rate, not a great response time. If we look at the database level, we can see that we've got relatively few sessions active inside the database and they're all on the CPU. We're not seeing any contention of any note to be concerned about. So the database looks fine. Everything looks great. So the clue to the bad performance actually comes from the operating system, in that if we interrogate the operating system, you can see that we're spending as much time inside the operating system kernel as we do in terms of user space. And really, you know, this is CPU being utilized for running the operating system that's not executing database code at all. And so you can see there's something not right with this system. And by looking at the database statistics, you can see that the actual number of connections or the logons per second to the database is almost identical to the transaction rate. And that in itself gives you the clue as to actually what is wrong with this application, is that the application is logging onto the database, executing a transaction, and logging off. And as a result, we're getting degraded performance because the operating system is working too hard. It's really difficult to get all the CPUs busy, and the response time, as you can see, is choppy and erratic. In summary, it's a suboptimal application. It's functionally correct, but it's not a performance application.